Even on the dinner table, you can still do that little bit of science. In fact, you can show everyone you're having dinner with how the solar system was formed. All you need is a little bit of water and empty it onto your plate, hopefully after you've already eaten everything on the plate itself. Give it a bit of a swirl. And you get a swirling around the outside, so all that water in there then is swirling round and round and round. And then inside this water, you can make the solar system. You drop a little bit of pepper onto it, anywhere onto it, and you'll see that it's rotating. And this then will be our all our rocky material for our planets and for the sun. You can help it along by giving it another bit of a swirl. And what you'll see is that they all start to accrete into the middle. We call it an accretion process, where they all start to go in towards the center. And that's what happened in our solar system. Very early on, all the harder material, all the heavy materials like iron, all the metals, all come in towards the center. And that's why we get the rocky planets and our Earth as well. And as the sun started to produce energy and it started to produce light and fusion reactions started to take place. And when the sun first ignited about 5 billion years ago, it sent out this shock wave that pushed all the gas past the terrestrial planets and out towards where Jupiter and Saturn is. And if you want to show that as well, just get a little bit of washing detergent and put it right in the center and you'll get that shock wave effect again with all the pepper. So you've got the terrestrial planets then in the middle with the sun and all the gaseous planets going around the outside. So next time you're at the dinner table, make sure to show those people how the solar system was made. And if you like this experiment, why not give it a thumbs up?